Elon Musk's company, SpaceX, is slowly but surely making headway into the military domain. Viewers may note that in October last year, SpaceX was awarded $149 million to build 4 military satellites. As per reports, the satellites will be designed to track intercontinental ballistic missiles, ICBMs, as part of a program known as the Tracking Layer. As per Space Development Agency, Tracking Layer will provide global indications, warning, tracking, and targeting of advanced missile threats, including hypersonic missile systems. This capability encompasses space-based sensing, as well as algorithms, novel processing schemes, data fusion across sensors and orbital regimes, and tactical data products able to be delivered to the appropriate user. The idea of using these specific satellites is to use their wide field of view to provide continuous coverage of the entire world so that the US military will have real-time information of any missile launch. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how Elon Musk's SpaceX could play a pivotal role in defending the US from enemy ICBMs. Let's get into the details. This video is sponsored by the free-to-play military vehicle combat game War Thunder. We talk a lot about military vehicles on this channel, but what about trying them out for yourself? In War Thunder, you can choose from more than 1,200 playable vehicles from the 1930s to the 1990s and go to battle on more than 80 theaters of war. You can fly aircraft, helicopters, drive tanks, and command ships of all types and sizes, which have been carefully recreated from their real-world counterparts. It's available as a free download on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. So grab your friends and give it a try. All viewers of Defense Updates that register using the link in the description below will also get a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time as a bonus. The Space Development Agency said in a statement, "The capability demonstrated by their Tracking Layer Tranche 0 will provide missile warning and tracking information to national defense authorities and tracking and queuing data for missile defense elements." As reported, these satellites are expected to be ready by September 2022, and each will have infrared capabilities for detecting and tracking advanced missile threats from low Earth. SpaceX's design for its satellites is based on its Starlink mega constellation, a proposed group of more than 12,000 satellites that will beam internet to Earth from orbit. Already, SpaceX has launched more than 700 Starlink satellites. While it's obvious that the military satellites will be different from the existing Starlink satellites, the specific details are withheld. Once a missile is launched, it will be detected and tracked by the SpaceX satellites present in the tracking layer. The tracking layer will work in partnership with the Space Development Agency's proposed transport layer, which will have around 300 and 500 satellites that will provide low-latency military data and connectivity worldwide to military assets. This way, any data that the sensors pick up in the tracking layer will be quickly transmitted to downstream systems. In case any enemy missile is determined to be a threat, the US military has 2 ways to neutralize it. Let's check them one by one. GMD, or Ground-Based Mid-Course Defense, is the United States anti-ballistic missile system that's being tested and developed with an aim to protect against incoming missiles by engaging them during the mid-course phase of ballistic trajectory flight in space. The system is designed to protect the US mainland. Ground-based mid-course defense is the only operational system that's available to the US military, which can intercept intercontinental ballistic missiles. Other systems like THAAD can take on only intermediate-range ballistic missiles. GMD is administered by the US Missile Defense Agency, MDA, while the operational control and execution are provided by the US Army and support functions are provided by the US Air Force. GMD has ground-based interceptor, which carries an exo-atmospheric kill vehicle that's designed to collide with the incoming missile to destroy it. Sensors include ground-based radars, upgraded early warning radars, forward-based X-band radars, FBXB, such as sea-based X-band platform, and the ANTPY-2, all developed by Raytheon. U.S. military recently achieved a major milestone when it comes to ballistic missile defense. In November last year, during a test, an SM-3 Block 2A missile launched from USS John Finn, DDG-113, successfully destroyed a Mach intercontinental ballistic missile target. U.S. Missile Defense Agency and the U.S. Navy said that the test met its primary objective, proving that an SM-3 Block 2A can engage an ICBM threat. U.S. Navy Vice Admiral John Hill, the director of MDA, also said the following in a statement. "This was an incredible accomplishment and critical milestone for the Aegis BMD SM-3 Block 2A program. The department is investigating the possibility of augmenting the ground-based mid-course defense system by fielding additional sensors and weapon systems to hedge against unexpected developments in the missile threat. We have demonstrated that an Aegis BMD-equipped vessel equipped with the SM-3 Block 2A missile can defeat an ICBM-class target, which is a step in the process of determining its feasibility as part of an architecture for layered defense of the homeland. U.S. is the only nation to have the ICBM interception capacity from a sea-based platform, and this capability will be deployed operationally pretty soon." The contract to SpaceX is part of the Space Development Agency's effort to procure satellites to detect and track intercontinental ballistic missiles, which can travel long distances and are challenging to track and intercept via land or sea-based sensors. While SpaceX has launched satellites for the U.S. military before, it's not yet built military satellites. SpaceX says it's able to build Starlink satellites rapidly at a rate of 120 per month. Their flat pack design allows them to be launched in stacks of 60 before they are then separated in orbit. Eventually, they'll be able to talk to each other via laser communication. Space Development Agency Director Derek Tournier, speaking to Space News, stated that SpaceX's proposal to use the same satellite design as its Starlink satellite was extremely credible. He added, "The selection is on technical merit, but the schedule takes top priority." This contract is a major boost for SpaceX as it continues to cement its position as the world's foremost private space company, while the U.S. military will gain from SpaceX's amazing expertise. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.